Hey guys, Cadigan Price here, founder of Cadigan, and I wanted to use this time to really walk you through what a Cadigan jacket's all about. I wanted to take the time to really just help you understand, you know, when you make an investment in a beautiful leather jacket, you know, things to look out for, and more importantly, you know, things we thought about in the design of our jackets. So, full grain Napa lambskin. So I want to start by, I mean, you can smell it. It's real leather. It's incredible. And something to really think about when you're buying a leather jacket is it full grain, top grain, corrected grain? We use full grain. It's the purest form. It actually gives each buyer a unique experience, meaning we go ahead and we don't necessarily fix or polish any of the things that may happen to the hide while the animals may be living or even in post-production. But what that does mean is we go ahead and we actually have to cut basically the best quality from the hide to use in our jackets. And so I just wanted to start there. We chose lambskin because it's kind of like the softest form. It's definitely the easiest when it comes to kind of putting on your jacket right out of the box. Cowhide's a little bit denser. It tends to be a little bit harder, like a little bit rougher when you put on and take some time to break in. Kind of think of like dress shoes that are really uncomfortable, give you blisters. And so we really wanted to focus on quality that just created a great experience. And even though the lambskin's a little thinner, it's actually just as durable. So like this is the same kind of quality that BMW, for example, uses in their cars for the seating and so forth, that Napa, right? So Napa means that it's been tanned usually with chromium, which adds like a nice kind of salt texture. And that just kind of softens the leather, but more importantly, it kind of seals it and protects it. And then we use water soluble colorants, which just enable us to limit any fading that's gonna happen on the jacket. So as you wear this jacket, you know, this is an investment, and at the price point, we absolutely want this to be with you for a lifetime, you know, if you may. And so, you know, those are some of the things to think about. There's other types of like, you know, synthetic, or people call it vegan, but that's just actually plastic. So this real leather here, as I mentioned, absolutely smells amazing. And even feels and basically just kind of fits right out of the box. So moving forward, you know, some things to think about. Anytime you see seams on a jacket or any garment, it actually increases the cost, right? So the more seams, that's the more labor, which means that somebody had to take the time to cut that, they had to take the time to sew that. But the cool thing is the more seams there are, actually the more form-fitting it can be, right? Because you can mold it. You know, traditionally when it's just one piece, you kind of have to like bend it and fold it. Whereas here you can kind of cut it to the perspective that you're going for, creating a lot more structure, but also a lot better quality fit. As I move through the garment, you know, there's some things I want to highlight. You know, in the second part of this, we're going to go through fit itself. But I really wanted just to kind of start with like, let's talk about the trims, right? So this is something we spent like over 25K on just in production and more or less development, R&D to test. We wanted military grade zippers. And the reason for it is I find that with a lot of your higher quality kind of jackets, a lot of guys actually at the very high end, $2,000 plus, obviously don't cut corners. But when you get into that sub 1000 category, there's a lot of areas where people start to kind of trip up in terms of design and production just to save money. One of them is zippers and the other is lining, which we'll talk about. And so these zippers here, you'll see they're almost like a quarter inch thicker than most zippers that you're gonna get in the market. So really important because super durable. Like I said, we built a jacket that we want to last forever. And so with that in mind, you know, these are basically concepts and ideas that are really important to us. As we've kind of further down the journey of the jacket, you know, some of the things I wanted to talk to you about was the lining. So it's really common to use polyester as a lining, 100% polyester. Although it's a breathable fabric, it doesn't quite have that sheen, doesn't kind of have that really nice texture and softness to the touch. That ultimately I think is an amazing opportunity for a leather jacket, right? Because your jacket can tell a story on the outside, but more importantly, it can tell a story on the inside. And so all of our jackets come with 100% acetate lining. And why this is so special is because acetate actually is traditionally from wood pulp, and acetate's highly breathable. It's almost like climate control. And there's a bit of thickness here, right? You'll feel like, you feel the fabric matrix, you feel kind of the density of this. So in the colder weathers, it's gonna really kind of keep you warm and be a perfect layer. But then in the not so cold layers, like when things are, you know, maybe a little bit cooler outside, but not too hot, but not too cold, or just more or less kind of mild, it's gonna allow it to breathe, which is super important. And it's gonna add a lot of kind of opportunity to wear this jacket more often. So one thing I wanted to take a moment to kind of talk to you about was the zipper extension that comes with our jacket. So this is pretty special. We talked about the trims themselves, but the zipper extension really allows basically additional layering options and for you to style and decide the fit of your jacket. So some of us obviously a little bit broader in the chest, Maybe more narrow in the waist, or some of us just kind of equal throughout, or some of us maybe kind of bit, you know, more extra space here and just not as big in the waist or in the chest. So the jacket zipper extension kind of allows you to tailor your jacket as you see best fit, like as I've done for you right here, right? So for me, the extension may be the best option. I'm wearing the jacket open, which I like to do. You know, I could also keep it kind of open like that, but you get the idea, right? Leather jacket versus a bomber jacket. So I know this is something that comes up quite often. So I just wanted to share with you guys kind of for our bomber jackets at the very least, what you're gonna find is that there's a ribbing fabric. So this ribbing fabric's along the hemline, it's gonna be along the collar up here and of the cuffs as well. And so the beauty of this is that if you have maybe a little bit shorter arms and you're concerned when buying your jacket about your sleeve length, this is perfect, right? The elasticity of this fabric is going to stop it from going past your wrist. And then also where it kind of benefits you, if you want something that's definitely more fitted and you want to feel it kind of along your body, that elasticity is naturally going to pull it into your body and hold it a little bit tighter. So I want to use this as an opportunity now to talk about fit. So what makes a Cadigan jacket in terms of fit really special is we've already kind of gone through the extension, right? Like this is a removable piece that, you know, basically allows you to decide what the look and fit of your jacket's going to be. But there's some other things we've done. And some of those include the armhole placement. So you'll notice with our jackets, the armhole placement is up here, which is pretty special, right? It gives you a lot of range of motion, and it really reduces the excess fabric that's in this area here. So that's something I want you guys to take note of, because you'll see, especially with a lot of American clothing, that the armhole placement's actually a little further down, which creates a much more boxy look. So we've kind of studied some of that high-end European fashion and really understood what they were doing right, which we felt was kind of the placement of the armhole to kind of allow you to have that mobility and do all those things you want to do. There's a little bit of stretch in the leather, but more importantly, it kind of gives you that tapered look and feel. So then the last thing I wanted to talk to you about with sleeve length, because I know this comes up quite often, which is, hey, I want a jacket, I want the sleeves to fit, right? So more often than not, you know, we're hopeful the sleeves fit great and there's no issues. Obviously, if really long arms, you know, hopefully the jackets fit, you know, that's not something where we can just kind of add additional fabric. But if you have shorter arms, you know, as I mentioned, the bomber jacket's a great option because the elasticity kind of stops the jacket from actually extending past your wrist. But on a jacket like this, this is the Prime, let's say the Maven, the Palace, you know, we use zippers, right, in order to kind of create that awesome appearance and also just effect along the sleeves. So I wanted to share with you two things. One is, you know, what we've done in terms of this jacket is we've actually gone ahead and we've moved the lining up to about 10 cm. So you could actually fold the wrist of this jacket quite successfully. And what you'll see is the leather continues, right? So this was a concept where we were like, you know what? We want to give people the option to roll the wrist and basically not impinder, like usually with the jacket, you'd see the lining right here, right? So kind of it's pretty obvious that there's like bright red right here that that's not meant to be. So that's like the simplest way if you just want to try that out or style your jacket in a different way. The big thing that I wanted to point out is every single one of our jackets has a seam right here. And so what we've done is we've created this seam. It's an additional cost to us in the manufacturing process. But when we thought about leather jackets, we thought about what would you do with a really high-end suit? How do you make a suit kind of meet your body and be altered accordingly? And so what's awesome about this seam, it's just below the elbow. You'll see it in all of our leather jackets, is that you could actually, a proper seamstress could open this up and just shorten it and then go ahead and reseal it. And the cost of this is nominal, right? Because we've already created a seam where they would just basically undo the stitching and redo the stitching. And what's so awesome about that is you have these beautiful zippers here, and we've basically protected from you having to go ahead, remove the zipper, basically interrupt the design and increase cost, right? Because anybody that's gonna remove this much fabric and these many different kind of points of view, like the zip, the suede, the inner lining, so on and so forth, it's gonna be kind of a nightmare. So we've made this super easy for you. So you've got a couple options, like I said, you got the bomber if desired, you've got the opportunity to roll the sleeves, and then last but not least, we have that seam, which is absolutely awesome because it really reduces the cost of getting your jacket kind of fitted for you. Hey guys, I just wanted to now talk about, you know, basically care for your jacket, right? This is something you've made an investment in. I'm sure you wanna wear this for years to come. And with that in mind, you know, more importantly, how do you care for a leather jacket, at least one that's Cadigan? So if you ever get any dirt on your jacket or maybe something that you're a little bit concerned about, we get a lot lot of questions about how to like clean the jacket. So one of the things I'd recommend is just take a wet cloth. So because of the way that these are tanned in the process of actually allowing it to become the leather that it is, you can actually take a cloth and just kind of rub it off, and most of that will just come right off. Sometimes, you're right, the jacket comes out of the box, maybe a crease here or there, or something that got imprinted by the zipper. Don't hesitate to use a steamer. Like, don't soak your jacket, but absolutely just kind of put some steam on it, and you'll see that the particles, just like our skin, like when we get our skin wet, you know, it puckers a little bit, but it also opens up. So it's the same concept. This is a, you know, real Napa lambskin. So as you kind of steam, it'll just open up, and some of those kind of imprints or so forth that may have happened absolutely will go away. If you're ever storing your jacket, I highly recommend buying like a suit hanger that's like 18 inches wide, if you may. If you look up like 18 inch hanger, you'll see it's a suit hanger, definitely wider in the shoulders. This just protects the shoulders, right? Like, you wanna make sure that your jacket always looks this great when you take it off the rack. And then other things to think about, which are really important. So we've just introduced a black leather oil. So don't be afraid to use this. This is something that you can buy on the website. And you know, what happens is our skin, right, has oils on it, or you may nick your jacket. And so this is perfect for just going ahead and basically adding and applying that to the jacket, and you'll just wipe it off, and it basically just replenishes this black finish and fills in any gaps. Kind of like if you get your car kind of nicked, sometimes there's these buffers that will just go ahead and fill in that. So yeah, you got your beautiful black, you know, car that still looks perfect. We know a lot of our guys travel, right? And so we were looking for something that we could include with the packaging, and this was perfect, right? This was something that we felt, this is a velvet dust bag. It's got our logo on it. And we knew that if we included this in the packaging, you guys could look to flat lay store your jacket if you didn't have any hanger space, or even awesomer, you could go ahead and basically travel with this, right? So if you were to go ahead and put this in a suitcase, you've now protected your bag. This has a nice thickness to it, and so that it can kind of take anything else that's pressing on your bag. And the idea was that this would be a great way to travel with your leather jackets, because we're hopeful you'll bring your Cadigan wherever you go. So with that in mind, you know, I appreciate your time. You know, hopefully we answered all of your questions. Look, we love these jackets. I love these jackets. You know, we've got thousands of happy customers. I'm glad you joined us on this journey, and we welcome you into the family, and we're excited for you to be a part of it.